my show. First of all, we have an international chef as our guest today. He's from Brazil, but he's worldwide known as a very good international chef. Almost my nephew. I saw him grow. And today, we're gonna cook some fish, barbecue fish wrapped in banana leaves.
E com essa coisa de eu voltar ao Brasil, sai em mim uma vontade imensa de fazer coisas brasileiras estando aqui em Angra, que é uma região que junta a coisa da mata com o mar, é uma coisa bem de Guarani mesmo, e fazer um peixe que remonta a essa cultura. Então faremos um peixe recheado na barriga com pirão, né, que é uma das coisas mais antigas dos índios brasileiros, assado em folha de banana. Então uma coisa bem orgânica, né, bem natural.
Ah, by the way, Jeff just came from Angola. In Africa for some time, and he's got excellent secrets, recipes, you know, many things. What's your favorite fish for doing this?
Robalo.
Robalo, I don't know how to call robalo. Sea bass. A non-fat fish. A fish that is like really lean, very little fat, white meat of course, barbecued and wrapped in banana leaves. Oh, that's really something out of this world. Really high cooking. I mean, not big jaw, but jaw anyway. Like we said before, we don't have the fish we wanted, so we're gonna change. We're gonna do a pargo, which is a very good fish, white meat, lean, and
prices are excellent, very convenient. This is one of the advantages of being like around Rio. Little fish in small cities, but with very good prices and excellent fish, as you all guys can see. Shrimp too.
Alho, azeite, cachaça.
That's it for our shopping. Now we're gonna go home and start cooking it. Wait a moment, hold on. See you guys later. See you guys in a while. Ciao. Have a quick stop so you guys can see the beauty of where we are. Take a look at this. Gorgeous, isn't it? That's where the fish came from, the fish we're gonna eat later. It's called Bahia de Angra dos Reis. Beautiful private islands like that. Now. Okay, let's have a little parenthesis. This kind of weird looking fruit is a very typical Brazilian fruit. I don't know if they have it anywhere else in the world. Maybe in India, I believe, Africa, but I'm not sure. It's called jaca. And some go up to 20 keys. It's delicious. It's interesting, huh? Kind of extraterrestrial, things like that. It looks very, very strange.
Thank you. Alô, Ibera, ó. Me chama Babosa. Cura tudo. João Gomes, tipo de Maranhão. Isso aqui, pra quem não conhece, é um tipo de coentro. Né? Tipo da América Central aqui, né? Cidade favorita.
To do the banana leaf wrapping. He's gonna tell us how it's done.
Tem algumas coisas importantes a gente saber antes de enrolar qualquer coisa na folha de bananeira. Primeiro, esse é o lado que deve para o alimento. E se você jogar um pouco d'água aqui, vai ver que a água escorre diretamente. Basta dar um talho aqui, ó. A gente segura até ali embaixo. As duas mais velhas a gente vai usar para ficar na parte de fora. Isso vai ser o que vai dar
no peixe. This is like barrican cilantro, which we have in the country. It's called chicory of Pará. Pará is an Amazonian state, a very big state in Brazil. It's got to be rustic. That gives, you know, a zinc, a zest to it.
Exatamente. Temos aqui cebolinha.
We have shallots.
Temos aqui pimentão verde.
Bell peppers.
Vamos aqui.
Now is the essence of it. I mean, we all doing like condiments for that. That is.
O que a gente tem aqui? A gente tem camarão,
shrimp,
temos mexilhão,
mussels,
e temos aqui vongole.
And we have vongole. I mean, the name, kind of a clam. Oh, my man, undernourished clam, but it's tasty.
Tudo é local. Tudo é desse mar que está aqui
everything
na frente da casa.
Everything is native. Right from the ocean that you guys have seen previously.
Tudo foi cozido numa água com um pouco de sumo de limão e sal, mais nada.
That was cooked with water and just a bit of lemon juice. We put olive oil. That's something that never can be out of our dishes. Some black pepper.
Salzinho.
Pinch of salt. Nice. It's a generous pincher. We start with the heavier ones, according to the chef. Heavier ones mean the ones that take longer to cook. Not for some water.
Não, tem nada de cozinhar não. É porque se não se mexer com as ervas aqui, vai destruir tudo.
Oh, it's nothing to do with taking time to cook. It's because if you mix it with the herbs you're gonna put later, it's gonna, I mean, destroy the herbs.
Então,
bell peppers.
Aí vamos faltar uma colher aí, produção.
Production. Now he's mixing up all the ingredients very delicately. You gotta treat food like you treat your wife or your dog. Claro. If food deserves refinement.
Então a gente vai colocar agora as ervinhas aqui. Né?
Now the herbs.
Bastante cebolinha.
A lot of shallots.
Quanto mais verde, mais saboroso fica, né?
The greener the better. I knew he was gonna get it.
Okay.
Okay,
happy to have
you. Well, I'm getting happy at least. Right. Well, he's adding, I said shallots, there are no shallots around. Scallions, I'm sorry.
Isso é um problema de quem fala mais de 12 idiomas, né?
Yeah, he just said that it's a problem who speaks more than 12 languages. Wow, this looks very nice. We're gonna add a little bit more of olive oil. Oh, I think we have something here that does not belong here.
Mas é natural.
No. I don't like this.
Abelha de jardim.
Oh, anyway, probably stings your larynx or something like that.
Na boca.
Wow.
Tá bom? É isso aí, ó.